He's so cute and handsome when he's asleep. Good morning, Foxy Coo. Come on, we need to start getting up.
No, 5 more minutes, Mom.
Foxy, I am not your mother.
Oh, sorry, Cargo. It was just so late when we got to sleep last night after I told you that.
I know, but you were all right when I was right next to you in bed last night, right?
Yeah.
Don't worry about it too much, Foxy Coo. Besides, today we're going to check out what Rio has in store for these newlyweds.
That's right, we're on a honeymoon!
You forgot that we were on our honeymoon?
No, I swear!
Alright, just making sure. Come on, let's get dressed and then we can head out. Sounds good?
Of course, anything for my sweet cargo wife.
What's wrong, Foxy Coo?
You're wearing the same outfit you wore last year. Why?
Well, I wanted to change my design to make me a girly girl again. As much as I like wearing that outfit from our latest adventure, I figured bringing this dress out and wearing it again. Plus, Frost made a few changes to it because I don't want people to get confused on how old I am. Plus, David and Jean gave me this handbag as a wedding gift for me. Let me just say that wearing this handbag with my dress makes me more attractive.
I remember when you showed up wearing that dress for the first time. Cargo? What the? How did you manage to survive? Also, what's up with your ridiculous look? You look stupid!
Stupid? I look stupid? You think this is funny? Picking on a 19-year-old cat with magic powers and making fun of her as she's dealing with a mental disease? Well, I have to say this. Hell fucking no. You better want to stop this right now. But since you took it way too far this time, you're in for an infinite world of pain, Baldy McFuckface.
Hey, that's my line.
Not anymore, you Monty Python and Ready Player One hating bitch face. Man, he can be such a pain in the ass at times. Eugene?
Laurel?
Yeah?
Have I ever told you that you look way better than how I first met you? Why see your hair just change color like that? It's like in the first X-Men film when Rogue got to that white streak in her hair from Magneto. And I'd like you better as a yellow cat than an orange cat.
I think we should stop by a hair salon to get my hairstyle changed up.
Why do you want to get it changed? It looks perfect as it is.
I'm referring to the pigtails, silly. And besides, have you ever seen a 21-year-old wearing pigtails?
Well, not really.
Exactly my point. Last thing I want is for someone to mistake me as a little kid when I'm not.
Now that would be embarrassing.
Agreed. So we better want to head down to the salon before we do anything else. Anyways, are you ready, my love?
Ready as I'll ever be. Oh, what's taking so bloody long? Should have been out of the salon minutes ago. Also, I'm surprised that the people working here spoke English when everyone in Brazil speaks Portuguese.
Foxy Coo, are you ready to see?
I'm ready.
Well, what do you think?
It's perfect. I love it.
Me too. So, where to now?
Let's head to the beach.
Alright, I've never been to the beach before in my life.
What about a first date?
Oh, right, I forgot.
Good Christmas, Cockgirl!
I'm so sorry. But anyways, let's head.
Race you!
Hey, no fair! You started without me! Wow, I never knew these kind of places exist!
What are you talking about? You were here with Sonic to help our friends from Dimension 76 take down the Deadly Six in Memphis back in 2016. Are you saying that you and Sonic didn't take time to do some sightseeing while preparing for the Battle of the Closing Ceremonies?
We did, but we mostly spent most of our time at the beach, thinking about how we were going to contribute our part in defending Rio de Janeiro since we were known as the Defenders of Rio.
Right.
But now that we don't have to worry about them coming back, we can spend more time with each other and what Rio has in store for us.
Exactly.
Where should we head after we're done shopping?
Last time I spoke with 76 Sonic, he recommended us to take the gondola up to Sugarloaf Mountain.
Isn't that where he confessed his feelings towards Amy before the Battle of the Closing Ceremonies?
Yep, that's what he told me.
Then we'll head there next. You ready to head?
Hold on just a moment, Cargo.
What is it, Foxy Coop? Hey, that jacket! It reminds me of what Akira Kurisu wore in Persona 5 Dancing Star Nights. Or should I say, Ren Amamiya. Or as I like to say, Amamiya, 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 let me go.
What?
Sorry. It's just that before we left for our honeymoon, Frost was telling me about a game/anime series called Persona 5. She got me hooked on it. Even though I don't technically own a PlayStation 4, but David does. Anyways, I think you'll look handsome wearing that jacket.
Are you saying I should try it on?
What else would I say? Forget about it?
Alright, I'll go put it on. Be right back.
Foxy Coo, do you have it on? Come on out and let me see it. Bloody hell.
Catchphrase thief!
I'm so sorry, Foxy. But you look stellar.
I know, right?
It's perfect for you. Just like how I'm perfect for you.
Of course.
I think we might want to purchase this and head over to the gondola up to Sugarloaf Mountain before we grab some dinner.
Seems like a good idea.
Wow! I've never seen so many lights shining down from the top of Sugarloaf Mountain!
I know.
Foxy Coo, are you okay?
Not really.
What's wrong?
Well, seeing the city light from high up reminded me of when I took Clarisse up to Big Ben to look out the view of London. And we even saw Buckingham Palace from high up.
Your ex-girlfriend? Can you tell me more about her? Come on, Foxy Coo. You mentioned a little bit about her when Lucas mentioned her back when you, Sonic, and I reviewed Mary Poppins Returns at the beginning of the year. Please, I want to know more.
What do you want to know?
Well, like how you two first met, and how you both felt the spark in your relationship. And what you both did for fun. And how she broke your heart?
Well, it all started back in high school, back in England. I remember one of my teachers assigning the class to work on a class group project. I didn't know who I was going to choose as my partner because, well, when I was 16, I was kind of too shy to speak to people.
Really? That is so unlike you. Wait, if you said you were afraid to talk to people, does that mean you had stage fright when speaking to a large group of people?
Not really. I was mostly afraid that I was going to say something I would have ended up regretting.
Oh, but where does Clarisse end up in your story?
I was getting to that. Anyways, as I thought I was going to work on the class group project by myself, this light-brained fox with dark brown hair came by my desk.
Hey, are you looking for a partner to work on the class group project?
Yeah?
Hey, there's no reason to be shy. Are you afraid that people are going to make fun of you?
Sorta.
Don't worry. How about this? You agree to be my partner, and in exchange, I'll help you overcome your shyness. How does that sound?
Sure.
There you go, Eugene.
How do you know my name?
Pretty much obvious at this point. My name's Clarisse.
Clarisse? That's right. You're the honor student with higher test scores than everyone in this school.
Yep, that's me. Now, how about we work on the best class group project ever and earn ourselves an A+?
Alright. Ever since that day, she and I worked on the best class group project ever, and she helped me break out of my shell.
Wow. I didn't know that Clarisse was a top-ranked honor student at your school.
I know. She got a lot of scholarships to top colleges in England, like Oxford and Cambridge.
Whoa. But when did you two felt a love connection?
Well, it was during lunch that same day. I was hanging out with Lucas. I couldn't stop thinking about Clarisse.
So, Eugene, how was class today? Eugene? Hello? Earth to Eugene!
Huh? Oh, hi, Lucas!
Eugene! Dude! What's got into you?
Sorry, Lucas. I'm just, well, can I ask you a question?
What is it?
How can you tell when you're in love?
Well, your palms start getting sweaty, and... Wait! Hold on! Why are you asking me that? Are you saying you're in love?
What? No!
Are you sure? Because when you came into the cafeteria, you started staring at the light brown fox. It's pretty obvious that you're in love.
What if I am?
Dude, what's wrong with you?
Well, wait, what do you mean?
I thought we're going to be bros till graduation day. Come on, Eugene! You can't ditch on me!
Lucas, listen to me. A lot of girls in the school haven't stood out to me. Though Clarisse was lucky enough to come and speak to me.
That's because she asked you to be her partner for your class group project.
Exactly. Please, Lucas. Let me be with her and see how it goes.
What's in it for me? How much is this worth in America?
$20.
Ah, heck yeah! I just scored me $20 in British pounds.
So, can I be with Clarisse?
I guess.
Thanks, Lucas. Hi, Clarisse.
Oh, Eugene. Hi.
Clarisse, I was wondering if you, well...
Are you asking me if I want to sit with you at lunch?
Yeah, that's it! Well, what's your answer?
I was just about to ask you once I was done with my conversation with some of my friends. So, where would you like to sit?
Maybe outside since it's a nice day.
Alright.
So, tell me, Clarisse, why are you the smartest in this school?
Well, I've been taught and raised to do well in my education, and succeed so that one day, I could get into Harvard.
Bloody hell.
Yeah, my mom and dad went to Harvard, and that's where they met. You could say they were college sweethearts.
That's so amazing.
But enough about me. I want to get to know you a bit more. You seem a bit more talkative towards me when we were working together.
Well, that's because I never thought I would be partnered up with someone who's smart and intelligent like yourself.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Thanks. So, what do you do for fun?
I would mostly spend time with my family. My dad came from America. My mom has lived here in England for a good chunk of her life.
Your father came from overseas?
When he found Mom, they knew they had a special connection.
So, it was this thing I keep reading about in some of my books. I think it's called Love at First Sight.
That's right. Also, how many books have you read?
I don't know. I've lost count. But my favorite book series has got to be Harry Potter.
Bloody hell, you like Harry Potter?
Yeah, wait. Are you saying that you like Harry Potter?
Not like, love it!
Whoa, I never thought I would meet someone who's a big fan of the Harry Potter books.
And the movies too.
My favorite character is Hermione. Because she reminds me of myself and how smart I am. I especially like this line from Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. It's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
Yeah, definitely schooled Ron there. Although in America, it's Sorcerer's Stone and not Philosopher's Stone.
I take it your favorite character is Ron Weasley, because you have scarlet fur, and you always say bloody hell a lot.
How did you know?
Lucky guess. What are you doing?
Nothing.
You can whistle too?
I taught myself how to whistle. It's actually a pretty common skill.
I wish I can whistle. I've read many books on how to whistle. But whenever I do it, I end up sounding like a tea kettle on the stove.
If you want, I could teach you how to whistle.
Would you?
Of course. Anything for you.
Clarisse didn't know how to whistle and she would always sound like a tea kettle?
She did.
Why does she remind me of Jean in a way?
I don't know, but you're a pretty good whistler yourself, too.
Why, thank you, Foxy Coo. So, when did you two officially become a couple?
It was during a school dance. She asked me if I was going to go, and I wasn't sure if I wanted to go. However, she told me that she was going to be by my side during the whole time.
I bet your parents were kind of suspicious that you were going to your school dance with a girl.
They were, but when she came to get me, my parents instantly changed their mind by how polite she was.
They weren't, like, suspicious about her because, I don't know, she was going to break your heart later on?
Now that you mention it, I think there was one time my parents were in another room, and I heard them talking about Clarisse.
Anyways, what happened at the school dance?
Well, we were all having a good time until a slow dance came up. We didn't know what to do since we were considered friends. I made the bold move and asked her to dance with me.
Did she accept your offer?
She did.
What happened while you two were dancing together?
I saw her eyes sparkle for the first time. She asked me if I had a girlfriend. That's when I thought my heart stopped because she was going to ask me to be her boyfriend.
And?
I responded with no. Then she asked me if I wanted to be her boyfriend. I couldn't believe what was happening as everyone was like staring at us.
Awkward!
It was awkward at first, but then I looked back at that night and realized that's how I got my first girlfriend. I answered yes to being her boyfriend. After the dance, we both hugged each other, as we were the luckiest students alive to find love.
You both didn't have your first kiss together? Well, that sucks.
Well, we did. I took Clarisse out on a few dates. We went and had fish and chips one night, and bangers and mash the other, and I took her to the local cinemas. I think you would very much like bangers and mash, but that's besides the point. But her first kiss happened when she asked me if we could go to Big Ben and check out the nightlife of London.
Oh, Eugene, this is the most prettiest thing I've ever seen.
But not as pretty as you.
Oh, stop it. You can see everything from here, even Buckingham Palace.
I know, right?
I've always read in my books that the view high above Big Ben takes your breath away, and they were right.
I'll bet you anything you're going to be accepted into Harvard when you graduate. What? Was there something I said?
Eugene, can I let you in on a little secret?
You don't have to keep secrets from me. I won't tell anyone what seems to be troubling you.
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't want to go to Harvard.
What? Why?
Most of my life I've been studying and reading a lot. I don't get a chance to live a teenage life like you and everyone else at school does. Also, a lot of people sometimes stare at me because they think I'm this top-ranked star student with all of the knowledge in the world. It gets awkward when you have millions of eyeballs staring at you. In fact, the past couple of days, that's all I ever see.
That's how I honestly felt for the past few weeks. I would get judged by any words that come out of my mouth. You, however, changed that for me, and I'm forever grateful.
And you made me break out of my shell and took me to places I only dreamed about seeing, instead of having my nose stuck in a book or a piece of paper. We both changed each other and how we view our lives. So thank you for always being there for me. For being so kind. For just being you.
Did you just kiss me?
Of course I did. You know, this is my first time kissing a boy.
This is my first time kissing a girl.
Your first kiss on top of Big Ben. That's so romantic.
Indeed it was. However, that wasn't meant to be.
Why? Oh, right.
Yeah, the day she announced she was breaking up with me.
There, there. I'm right here for you. Now, tell me what happened on that day.
What happened after school a week after our first kiss? Hey, Clarisse, sweetheart, how are
you? Eugene, we need to talk.
About what? What did I do?
I don't think we should be seeing each other anymore.
What? Why? What the bloody hell is going on?
Eugene, I'm sorry, but I'm breaking up with you.
What?
I wouldn't bother talking to you ever again.
No, no, no. This isn't happening. This has to be a bloody nightmare I'm having. Wake up, Eugene! Wake the bloody hell up!
It's not a nightmare. It's real. Anyways, I gotta go. Goodbye, Eugene.
What the hell? She didn't give you a reason? Why she was breaking up with you?
Yeah. It really hurt me that day.
Now that's just messed up!
And ever since that day, I found myself alone and depressed. I would always find myself crying at school because of the heartbreak I was going through. I wouldn't even talk to my parents or my sister after my breakup.
Damn.
How it
I do. You ended up traveling to America where you started college, the pain you felt wouldn't go away, you thought of suicide, and then you saved my life after my ex-boyfriend broke up with me.
Exactly.
Foxy-Koo, listen to me. Forget about Clarisse. I had a feeling she only used you to get more popular with herself. She can pretty much fuck herself for all I care about because she doesn't know what true love is. I, for one, showed you that because every day I'm with you, it makes me happy. Look at me from when you first met me. I was sad and depressed ever since I faced a near-death experience. Look at me now. I am now happy that I'm going to be spending the rest of my life with you. And there's no one else I would want to be my husband. You are it, Eugene the Scarlet Fox.
Capaldi.
Huh?
My last name's Capaldi. Kind of like the 12th Doctor from Doctor Who, Peter Capaldi.
So, My full name is Laurel Michelle Capitelli.
If you want, you can call yourself Laurel Michelle Smith Capaldi.
I like that better than Laurel Michelle Capaldi.
Oh, Cargo, I love you so much.
I love you more.
And I love you most.
Sorry, I guess after you told me that story, it made me hungry. How about we head down from here and grab a bite to eat?
All right, Cargo. Seanic! Seanic, what are you doing here? The mountain's on fire! Where the bloody hell did you get that knife? Seanic, what the hell are you doing? Get that knife away from you! Seanic! Sorry, I just... Seanic. He can't be. Should I tell Laurel about what I saw? Get a hold of yourself, Eugene. She'll think you're delusional. But that was no ordinary vision. Did Seanic really, really try to attempt suicide? I hope he didn't.
There you are! I've been waiting for like 30 minutes! Where were you? I was about to call you! Foxy-Coo? Is something wrong?
Oh, no! Everything's fine!
Are you sure?
Yes! There's no ninja threat! No suicides here, am I right?
Suicides? Alright, Foxy-Coo, what's going on? You better not be keeping secrets from me! We're married now, and I don't want you to be keeping secrets from your wife.
Oh, alright. You got me. I'll tell you what's going on.
Hold that thought. Let's head inside and get our sushi. Haven't had sushi in a while.
I didn't know you liked sushi.
There are some things you don't know about me. Alright, Foxy-Coo, tell me what's up. Why did you say there are no suicides?
Well, when you were heading towards the gondola, I saw this vision.
A vision? Usually it's Skylar that can see into the future. But that's not important now. What did you saw in your vision?
I saw the entire mountain on fire. And then, I saw Seanic.
Seanic? What was he doing in Rio de Janeiro?
Like I said, it was a vision. I saw him grabbing a knife, and he aimed it at his stomach.
Oh no! What did he do with that knife?
He stabbed himself with it! Oh no! I'm so bloody scared that something's gonna happen to Seanic.
Well, luckily we're heading home tomorrow. Maybe when we're done unpacking our things, we can head to Dimension 76 and see if he's alright.
I just hope nothing bad happened to him.
Me too, because Seanic's like another brother to me. I don't want to lose anyone I care about.
Don't worry, Cargo. You won't lose me.
Oh, Foxy-Coo. Let's just finish our sushi and just hang out around town before we head back to our hotel room.
Sounds good.
Don't worry, Foxy-Coo. Seanic's gonna be fine. I promise.
I hope so.
I know so. Just keep thinking positive and take deep breaths if you feel scared.
Right.
Hey guys, we're back!
Not the side I wanted to see upon arriving back.
What's going on? It's Seanic.
Tell me,